We are here with Austin Visentainer. Say what's up, Austin.
What's up, guys?
All right, buddy. How's it going today?
Good, man. I was just skating, getting ready for the local contest that we have tomorrow.
What's that called?
It's called the Coeur d'Alene Classic.
Oh, where? So you're up at Coeur d'Alene?
Yep.
Hell yeah, that park looks sick. I still need to get out there.
It is really sick. Super fun.
Fuck yeah. So, did you start out skiing or anything, or did you start straight out snowboarding?
No, I started straight out snowboarding because, like, these kids that I was neighbors with, they all, like, skated and had a mini ramp, and I was always, like, super, super juiced on, like, skating and shit. And so my dad, like, got me the skateboard, and then, like, all those kids I was neighbors with snowboarded, too. So, like, I think the winter after I started skating, my dad took me up to the mountain for the first time. And, like, yeah, that's when it all started up at Mount Spokane.
Damn. Hell yeah. And you were probably, like, six at that time?
Yeah, I think I was, like, six.
Wow. And you've just been snowboarding ever since?
Yeah, pretty much. Snowboarding and skating ever since then.
Hell yeah. Yeah, you've actually told me a few times, you know, how much of an influence your dad has been on your snowboarding. Can you tell me a little bit about him?
Yeah, my dad's, like, the biggest supporter. It's so sick. I think it comes from, like, my dad was, like, a professional golfer when he was my age.
Oh, wow.
And so, like, I think that's where, like, he just wanted me to, like, do whatever I wanted and whatever I thought was, like, sick when I was younger. And so, like, he was always super supportive. And he, like, would take me to all the local contests, like, even around Seattle and, like, Portland and shit. And, like, same with my mom, too. Like, they both, like, would take me literally all over the place.
That's awesome. Did he snowboard at all, or did he, you were the first one to snowboard in your family?
Yeah, I was the first one to snowboard. My mom and dad ski.
We saw a bunch of skiing from you out of this winter, dude. You were fucking doing, like, the rails and shit.
Yeah, it's so sketchy.
You hit the down tube. You did the fucking, I don't know what they call that, fucking ski slide same way.
Front bump same way. Quarter turn.
Fucking damn, dude. That's crazy. I would think I would kill myself, like, instantly.
It's pretty fun, because, like, Riley and I would always ski when, like, whenever it was shitty at the mountain, which is honestly a lot around here, like, we would just switch with our skier homies. And so, like, I don't know. I actually skied for the first time at Wendell's.
Yeah. Damn, like after you were 6 years old, or, like, you know?
I mean, well, yeah, my dad was, like, super supportive on that. It would, like, hook me up and fucking... Damn. I got to go to Wendell's, like, for 4 summers, I think, something like that.
Did you skate there, too, obviously?
Yeah, that's why I never went to High Cascade, because, like, Wendell's skate park was way sicker.
Dude, fuck yeah. It's so sick how they, you know, like, completely converted over there.
Yeah, it's way sicker now, I think.
Yeah, way better of, like, a facility.
Yeah, not for sure.
Hell yeah. So, who would you say your favorite riders right now are?
Favorite riders right now?
Like, who's really, like, you know, stand out for you that you're like, damn, like, you know, I've been watching a bunch of their shit?
Well, I mean, I feel like Jed Anderson's comeback, like, that shit's sick. Seeing that, like, was huge inspiration to, like, go film street shit and take that more seriously, I guess, because I always, like, thought Jed was really sick when I was younger. So, like, seeing him drop off and then come back like that was really sick.
Yeah, dude, like, he really deserves big props.
Dude, like, yeah, he's a fucking boss, dude. Oh yeah,
insane. But so with that, what type of riders don't you like? have you know, an opinion of?
I mean, like, honestly, I don't really like to hate on, like, any kind of snowboarders, because we're always doing the same shit, but, like,
yeah.
I don't know, all those, like, slope-style kids and shit like that, I just feel like they rub me the wrong way.
For real.
I don't know, just, like, the experiences that I've had with, like, I mean, like, I've met a lot of sick kids doing contests, but, like, it's, like, half and half, really, like, a lot. Dude, I mean, I don't know.
Do you want to talk about maybe, well, let's just put it out there. Both me and Austin have both kind of came up in the contest scene. Do you want to talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, I used to do a lot of contests because, like, I don't know, I guess I thought it's how you could, like, get out in the snowboarding industry or, like, get your name out in the industry. Just because, like, growing up, the X Games were on TV and, like, Do Tour and shit, and so I always, like, loved to watch that.
Yeah.
And
no,
so I would do those contests, but I never, like, it was always sick to ride with, like, all the homies and, like, hit the contest course, but when it came down to it, I just, like, I don't know, never was feeling it. And so that kind of, like, led me to other options. And
I feel like when you're being raised, you kind of, like, there's really only one outlet that your parents, like, especially your parents aren't snowboarders, you know, they really push you towards that one outlet because, like, it's the only outlet most parents are like, oh, well, my kid could probably make money doing this. Or it's like, you know, they really don't have, you know, that maybe just, like, the kid's best intentions in mind all the time.
I definitely would agree with that.
Yeah.
I never necessarily felt like that. And, like, I don't know, my parents just kind of, like, let me do, like, whatever in snowboarding. So, it was, like, when I told them I didn't want to do contests anymore, it wasn't, like, I don't know. I feel like most kids, like, their parents might freak out, you know? Or, like, cut them off. They're like, fuck this, you're done, man.
Yeah, you don't have to tell me, but my dad was definitely, like, he was very supportive of me doing whatever I wanted, but he always gave his opinion. So he's very opinionated, and he was one of those, everyone at the mountain didn't like, you know, his opinions about snowboarding, and he was the only dad that was, like, really, like, a fucking hardcore dad.
Yeah.
I didn't like that growing up, you know, it changed my perspective of snowboarding when I grew up, and I was like, well, I definitely took it way too seriously when I was younger.
Oh, yeah, totally. I feel like I kind of did, too. Like, I feel like we both mellowed out. It's just, like, I don't know, I feel like it's all for ourselves now, which is way sicker, rather than trying to, like, impress judges or shit like that.
100%. I love, like, being just, like, out there and just, like, hyping up the homies and just being able to, like be able to feed off each other, just, like,
yeah.
Hell yeah. So, what brought you out of, like, obviously we kind of got into, like, what brought you out of competitions, but was it mainly, you know, just, like, you were vibed out, or did you just, like, stop wanting to compete?
Yeah, it was just, like, I don't know, it was just, like, weird riding in front of people, so I guess I did get kind of, like, vibed out in the whole contest thing. And I never, like, was able to hit really nice jumps all the time either, because where I grew up, like, the jumps sucked.
Yeah, let's get a little about that. Let's talk about Mount Spokane and where you grew up and kind of, you know, how the parks have kind of influenced you throughout the years.
Yeah, I mean, Mount Spokane is, like, super fun, and it's a great home mountain, but it's just, like, not somewhere you can necessarily progress, only to, like, a certain amount, you know. They offer, like, rails and jumps and everything, but it's just, like, you can only learn so much.
What could you say is, like, some of the things that, you know, make it that way that, you know, really, you know, like, compared to, obviously, now Mission, where you were working this past year, like, what were the differences between a mountain like that and Mission that, you know, obviously kept you from progressing?
It's just, like, I mean, I learned everything I can and, like, the basics of snowboarding in Mount Spokane. And just, like, but once you go to, like, a place like Mission and where you have, like, say and what goes up and shit, I feel like that was a big part of it, too, being in Mission. We wanted.
Yeah, it's like that small, like, little, like, basically skate park feel where it's like, you know, if you want to make something, it's not hard to do, and it's like right there. It's not like you have to really put much effort. So let's talk about, like, Stevens compared to Mission. Like, when you were working at Stevens the year prior, like, I know you had some mishaps, you know, working under Big Mike over there.
Yeah. It's just, like, a way different vibe. Mission almost reminded me more of Mount Spokane with how laid back it was, because Stevens is just, like, I mean, especially now with Vail, it's, like, way more personal. But it was just, like, frustrating not being able to have that much input at Stevens. Like, not being able to be hands-on with the teachers, I think that's super important for train parks. Like,
what what really like forced you, or like what made you want to leave Stevens and start working for Mission?
The rope tow was always sick, and just like how they set up features at Mission is just so much better.
Could you explain like the ways that, you know, make the parks better by the way that you guys set it up over there?
So, I mean, I think the biggest thing is that at most mountains they set rails with cats, obviously, because it's like a lot faster. But the overall quality of the feature when you set it hands in is so much better, because you can really perfect a feature rather than having a large machine do it and not being able to get like the little imperfections out.
Like those parks that make giant fucking basically 10, 20 foot booters onto the rails?
Yeah, like the lips at most mountains are
dumb.
Just too big, like they're just stupid.
Street style or nothing. Fuck everything.
Yeah, it makes it so much harder to learn tricks when it's like a fat ass thing.
For real. Yeah, dude. It's like, you know, we go and we hit all these other different mountains and stuff, and we go so many different places, and like, in my opinion, like, there's only a few mountains in the world that really make their rails right, and that's like usually rope tow parks, and like specifically, you know, like, you know, parks that are like very core and like designed for rails, and like they're not really the biggest jump parks, you know.
Yeah, I agree, dude. Fired up.
Yeah. So, Park Street or Powell?
I mean, I feel like right now I'm definitely more with, like, the street stuff. So,
definitely. Yeah, I want to see more of the Powell out of you, though.
Like, to be honest. We'll definitely have to film it.
Yo, if Jake Rose comes along with us next season, he says he has an extra sled for you.
Yeah, he said he has two sleds.
Yeah, so we all have a sled.
Dude.
I don't know, we just gotta get you a beacon.
Oh, so down, dude, I'll fucking buy one.
Dude, fuck yeah. That would be super, super sick.
I'm so sick.
Oh.
When was your first full part for skateboarding? Yeah. What year did you start that?
First one? Honestly, that was like, I think it was like 3-4 years ago.
What's the name of that movie?
The first one was Folklore.
It was Folklore.
Like, it's probably like 50 minutes long. Maybe.
Where could you find it now?
Dude, I don't even know if it's online, honestly. You have to hit me up.
Oh, word. Hell yeah. So you really have been like putting out street parts for skateboarding for a little bit.
Yeah, dude. That was my first one, and like, I think I was like 18 when I filmed it. 18, couple flips when I was 17.
Oh yeah. And obviously you're still doing that now. Are you filming with the same guys?
Yeah, pretty much the same dude.
Sick. How's that going this year?
I mean, I haven't filmed really that much this year, just because like my leg, I'm trying to let it heal.
Word. What happened to your leg?
Well, yeah, this last piece was just like when I split my shin open and shit.
Oh, fuck. That's still... Damn. Let's talk about that for a second. Oh, my God. This was probably like one of the gnarliest injuries I've ever like encountered from a rail. But honestly, thank God that you walked back.
Fuck that shit.
What exactly happened during that?
So we had this really nice down rail admission with no panels and 42 feet long, and there's like a lot of legs on it, and I was trying to do a cab two on, I wanted to do cab two pretzel, like, because I just learned those, so I was like trying to battle that out, and I just like thought it was going to be so good on the one I was like that fucked me up too, like at first it felt so good. I was like so mad.
Were you like close to landing the cab two pretzel?
I mean, not really, because it was pretty early in the day, and it was like the first time I tried it on the rail. So I did like, I was doing like cab two regular, and I got a couple of those.
This was on the 42 foot down rail with no skirting on it as well. That's
yeah,
fucking psycho.
And, like, because I had learned them on the top rail. I did a bunch, like, I think the day before, like, a few days ago.
So, was it the down rail or was it... Oh, it was the down rail. It wasn't the elbow. You were doing it on the down rail.
Yeah, like
the one with the closing.
Yeah, with that rail also fucking up too.
Damn, dude. I remember you doing that. I wish someone got a good clip of that. That was fucked.
So I was trying to cap two onto the long rail and fucking like started going MJ, fucking caught my, was like getting on my toe edge and like.
So you went MJ on like a, what is it, half inch round tube?
Yeah, dude. Like, not right away though. It was like fucking like right in the middle. And I was like slipping out and I was just like trying to like grab the rail or something. And like, dude, I don't even know what the fuck happened, but my board like came off the rail and then I just like hit my fucking shin so hard on the rail.
You like went in the inside, like under the skirting, right? Like where the skirting would be. So you like clip on the post.
Yeah, I like came in like right in the middle of the rail, like vertically, like right on the second post.
Jesus.
And like right on the corner, and just like fucking hit my shin and just like torqued my knee so hard.
Dude, if people saw the pictures, this was like probably like a 2-inch diameter square, like straight up gash.
It was like, bad. And like at first, like when it first happened, because I like knocked the wind out of myself too, because I like hit the rail, like I fucking got closed in, and then like fucking hit my ribs on my left side. So I don't even know how, dude. And so I like knocked the wind out of myself, and like when I came back to it, like you guys were all fucking around me.
Yeah, and, like, I remember that.
Got my board off, and we like, you guys helped me walk over, and I didn't even think that my shin was split open. Like my knee just hurt so bad. And as soon as I like lifted my pants up and saw, dude, I was just like fucking so dumb.
Oh, dude, I just, yeah. All I can remember is how deep that shit looked.
Dude. And there's just so much blood, dude.
That was gruesome, dude.
Yeah, because I mean, honestly, I was like chilling at that point. Like, I wasn't even, like, I had so much adrenaline going through my body. It's just like,
how long did it take for the pain to actually kick in?
Dude, like, when we got to the hospital, it was like, I don't know, like 4 hours probably.
Yeah.
Dude, like, I don't know, because I got super fucking baked before we went to the hospital, too.
That's good.
We went to the house first.
Yeah. You guys didn't have, like, any medicine at the house that you took, or?
I just took ibuprofen. I didn't have, like, any drugs or anything.
Dang. Yeah, always have to have an extra stash at the house.
Yeah, I took fucking, like, a lot of CBD. And, like, I honestly smoked a lot of weed and just chilled.
Dude, I remember this one time. Matt Robb fucking broke his arm up at Mission. And I had to drive him down to the hospital. And we were trying to go as quick as we could to the hospital so he couldn't feel the pain, you know, because I hadn't kicked in yet. And I was just, like, flying down that hill as fast as I could to get on the hospital. It was, it was fucked, man. That shit sucks, having to drive down that and be fucking injured.
But, yeah, the fucking nurse at the hospital, when they were taking me back, fucking hit my leg on, like, the side of the wall. And, like, that's when it really started. Like, dude, it was so fucking bad.
Dude, fuck, you were just getting some shitty help everywhere you went.
Straight up, dude. Well, like, the lady that stitched me up was super nice.
That's good. Was that the free clinic, or was that the actual hospital?
No, it was at the hospital, because I was fucking on the clock when it happened.
Oh, no worries. Yeah, so, how did Mission, like, they didn't really do much about that no skirting rail after that, which is pretty tight. They kind of, like, just wrote it off as like, that was just an accident.
Shit happened. Honestly, I'm not even sure if Clayton knows exactly. I'm sure he knows, dude. But like,
but he probably just didn't bring it up to them.
Yeah.
So, should we talk about Missions Corporation at all? Like, the management that's running the mountain? Or if you have any input?
I mean, the only thing I really want to say is, like, I just feel like it could be so much sicker up there, you know? Like,
oh, I know.
It has so much potential. Like, it could be so much more.
Yep.
it really is such a cool mountain, but it's just like, I don't know. Just working at the mountain is very difficult, I think, anywhere you go. Like, same with students. It's just like hard to work where you're trying to like have fun all the time. Like, that shit doesn't work well.
Yeah, they kind of like fuck you guys over with making like the fun zones and like stupid things that you guys don't really, you know, need at all, but making you work on it just for fucking like appeal, just for stupid fucking weekenders.
Everyone that doesn't know what the fun zone is at Mission Ridge, it's not a fun zone at all. It's like some big ass metal corrugated tubes for people to ride through, and we had to set up a lot of fencing every single day. And it took, Mission Ridge used to have a ballpark, like
Before that, they had jumps up there. It was jumps, then they turned into a ballpark of the crush.
Jumps. Ballpark was really sick, and I wish we could have had a full potential with ballpark, because it was not very sick at all.
They blew it.
The fun zone is whack.
Yeah, they're supposed to, like, they're supposed to double them in size. Like, I think they're, like, going to be combining two of them together.
Well, yeah, because honestly, the ones they had last year were kind of sketchy when it had snowed a lot, because you would definitely have to duck. Like, my head was just barely under it, but I wouldn't even feel comfortable riding completely straight up through that thing.
Like, it's all about the appeal of those things. They literally have no... They're not fun for anybody except for just, like, you know, someone who's been there one time out of the season.
Yeah, straight up. It's just for the people on the weekend, but it's not worth it, in my opinion.
Yeah, no, 100%. What are your goals for, what's your plan for next season?
Well, I think I've decided to just set out and film as many street clips as possible, mainly with you and Andre, and hopefully Coach too.
Fuck yeah. Hell yeah, that's gonna be dope. Can't wait, I'm super excited for that.
Yeah, I can't wait.
Hell yeah. Yeah, I'm sure we can get, you know, passes and tickets to any, you know, resorts we're trying to go to as well.
Thank you so much.
Hell yeah.
I think about it every single day at work. I'm like, this is why I'm here.
Dude, fuck yeah. I'm super excited, too, because I feel like, you know, we didn't have that type of mentality last season. Like, we didn't go into last season thinking that we're going to film a, you know, a movie or anything.
Not at all. Like, that's what I'm trying to do this season, put out a movie. And if we could come up with the 12 minutes of footage, just not even trying, like, we actually set out a full season to film a movie, I think we could produce some good shit for sure.
Fuck yeah. Now that we're on the subject, let's talk about East Bumfuck Shithole for a second. Let's talk about the amount of time that you had, because that's really what I'm trying to get at, like. It was obviously, you know, Austin was working at Mission Ridge the whole season and had really, you know, a full schedule working there, and it was definitely difficult to get him off, you know, to be able to film with us whenever, you know, we were able to, because obviously you don't get to pick when the snow comes. So he only was able to probably come out and film with us this season like 7 to 10 times.
Yeah, I feel like maybe 10
at most. Yeah, obviously, the clips that you came out with were fucking hammering, like, you...
Yeah, I mean, we try to go to as many spots as we could.
I mean, like, with what we have, too, especially being in East Bumfuck Nowhere, we're literally, like, not in the city, and we're trying to look for the city.
Yeah. Like,
we're not Spokane.
For one, like, most of the spots are so far away from each other.
Yeah.
So difficult.
Like, if we didn't probably, you know, really hype this up at all, but we only filmed in Wenatchee and Chelan. Only those two towns. Nowhere else.
And, like, yeah, that's pretty much it. But I had one clip in Wenatchee.
You had one clip in Leavenworth. But, yeah, that was, yeah. You know, that was more B-roll.
Yeah.
We didn't really get anything crazy over there.
No. Super mellow.
But, like, yeah, literally two fucking towns in eastern Washington that really have not that many spots.
No. I mean, there's, like, a couple cool ones, you know?
I guess a decent amount to make East Bumfuck Shithole, but...
Yeah. I mean, like, I really like that down rail that we got kicked out of that goes into the road.
Oh, yeah. What about the down rail with the little curve at the end with, like, the down flat downs next to it? That lady hyped us up to. She fucking gave us a link.
Oh. Wait, which one?
The secret spot. Remember when we went to the sea rail at that, you know, like, it was, like, the bed and breakfast? And...
Oh, yeah.
And then the woman was basically like, yeah, like, the owner said that you actually can't hit this spot, but I know of a better spot that you guys can go to. And it had,
yeah,
like, a bunch of down rails that were crazy, and two down flat downs.
Dude, we're going to have to go back there, because those were really sick. Not enough for the other ones, really. But
I know that line got to go down on the down flat down to the down rail that we were hitting.
Dude. Yeah.
To the drop after. Oh,
dude,
my God.
Definitely trying to hit that up for sure.
Fuck yeah, that whole zone, just like going, taking that left at the Texaco, is fucking yeah. That was all Andre too. Andre was the one that was like, I just want to go down there and I want to go into those, like, you know, resort, like the vacation homes, and just like search every little one of those alleyways, and he found a lot of shit. Like, remember I showed you those photos, and we went to some of the spots, and like they were insanely fucking huge.
That one creeper rail against the rock.
That's the one I was just thinking of. Yeah. Dude, it's so doable. I got dreams about that rail.
Dude, yeah. We're definitely going to have to do something.
Yeah, I mean, definitely throughout the season, I want to be here if they got snow. But like we're saying, traveling is my main goal as well.
Me as well. I'm trying to go to as many cool places as we can go.
I know, right? Like, going to Minnesota sounds fucking awesome.
Yeah, I'm super fucking bad.
Hell yeah. I'm fucking, yeah. This is gonna be dope. I'm glad that we actually, you know, are finally setting out to film a movie instead of, you know, just kind of winging it and let it kind of happen. Because it feels like we could actually get a lot more done than what we've really had in the past. It seemed like this past year, you know, kind of just happened, whereas... like, you were working, and, like, it was hard to, like, link up with time with you, but next season, we're really focusing on straight up just filming.
Oh, yeah, dude. I'm not trying to, like, really work at all this year. I think I'll have
to. Fuck yeah. I think that we, as, you know, the snowboarders that we're at right now, like, you know, kind of where we are, we need a whole season to really, you know, push ourselves and, like, go the extra distance.
No doubt.
Fuck yeah. So, what companies do you support?
I support Adidas, Snowboarding, Capita. I mean, like, my sponsors are, like...
No, just... I mean, yeah, your sponsors and any company that you, you know, back that you like, fucking, I don't know, ship in the past.
I've always really, like... Adidas, now they do snowboarding for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Adidas, like, I really like their shit. I think it's sick.
Yeah, any companies that you don't like?
Fuck, dude. I mean, I don't even know. There's definitely probably quite a few companies I don't like. But
do you like smoking snowboards?
I mean, yeah, now that I don't ride smoking snowboards. Cool. I like all those dudes. Like,
do you like Nike?
I'm pretty bummed on Nike, to be honest.
Yeah.
The fact that they backed out of snowboarding, like how they did, was just not very cool, in my opinion.
Like, they were the Adidas of their day, you know, like how Adidas is now. Like, Nike was like that in 2012.
Yeah, I thought Nike was really sick.
Yeah, me too.
But when they did that shit, it was not very sick at all.
True. That's where kind of my next question is, what type of movies and, you know, like, snowboard movies basically were, you know, your influences?
I mean, when I, like, grew up, I always watched all, like, the Mac Dog videos.
Fuck yeah. You guys like TVs?
Yeah. Just pretty much any snowboarding video. Like, I always thought the forum videos were really sick.
Yeah, dude, fuck. Going back to any of those, like, forever and fuck it and fuck it.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Who are your biggest influences, like, you know, fucking, say, late 90s, early 2000s snowboarders?
Dude, like, J.P. Walker.
Yeah, you like, Devin Walsh was super sick. I really like his style.
Yeah, like Peter Lyon, super sick.
Dude, like Daniel Spring. I think he had, like, really, really good style for his day.
Yeah. But, dude, I don't know, like, watching the old snowboard videos, the style.
Yeah. You really, like, get the feel for, like, how fucked up snowboarding was back then when you strap into one of those old snowboarders, too. Try one of those fuckers out.
I can't even imagine.
Goddamn plank. A plank with, like, the loosest fucking bindings and boot studs you ever had in your life. Like, ankle breakers.
It'd be so sketchy, dude. Like, I have my bindings, but I just don't.
Seriously. So, smoke weed, drink, or party? Or, well, all.
I'm not gonna do anything. Smoke weed and chill.
Yeah, that's your normal.
Especially
the way you go.
It's just like, smoke so much weed, I was kind of over it.
Yeah.
I just smoke weed every once in a while.
Yeah.
But, I don't know. I'll like drink some beers every once in a while. I'm like,
word.
I like,
yeah, I'm just like mellow, like, you know, moderation.
Yeah, I don't really do anything too crazy.
Word. Just working, making that money for next season?
Yeah, pretty much.
So, we kind of got to get into this. I'm sure people kind of want to know what, you know, that whole shit was about. And I think I'm, you know, where I'm going with this. You want to kind of shed some light on those Instagrams that you put out about you and your girlfriend proposing that she was possibly pregnant?
I was really just trying to, like, clown off people.
Yeah? clown on them how?
I don't even know. Like, I was just, like, not able to do anything for so long, and I was so bored all the time. Just, like, I couldn't be down at hood, and so, like, I haven't seen all my friends in a while. So I was just, like, I don't know. I thought it would be really funny.
But, what type of feedback did you get from all your friends?
Honestly, I got so many messages that people were so hyped.
Really?
Yeah, dude.
Damn, dude, that's crazy.
Like, it was like, honestly, when I told people it was a joke, nobody really took it badly either, which I was really surprised. Because, like, after I did it, I was like, fuck. I don't know, I felt, like, weird about it.
I feel it. Did you, Yeah, it was crazy how our whole family got into it, too. I'm sure a lot of people, you know, thought it was real.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm obviously going to, you know, we could edit a lot of this shit out if you don't want to put it on there, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. No, 100%. So, kind of like, what is your relationship with your girlfriend now? Like, is that, you know, kind of the route that you guys are trying to go is to have a family and, you know, do that thing? Or where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Nah, I'm just trying to chill. Like, I definitely don't want to have a kid or anything like that. And, like, that was another reason why I thought it was so funny. It's like, I don't know, any of my friends are like, now how, like, serious I've been about not having kids. I feel like,
word,
now I just want to snowboard and shit.
Fuck yeah. I'm sure a lot of people want to hear that. You know, definitely want to see you snowboarding.
Yeah, like, that's all I'm trying to do right now is snowboard. So, skate. Like, I don't know, maybe a long time in the future. I don't know, like, 10, 15 years down the road. Like, really.
Definitely. We all got time, though, you know? It's like, I feel like a lot of people, you know, like, since they don't have the type of things that we have, like snowboarding, like, they don't really have outlets like we do. Like,
yeah.
Really, like, you know, go to high school, go to college, get married. Like,
yeah,
kind of like, you know, what we're told.
Like, I know a lot of people that have kids and, like, are super stoked about it, you know? Like, I think that's sick, but it's just not something that, like, I'm, like, into right now.
Yeah, I know, I feel it. 100% though, like, I'm really glad to hear that, you know, you're amped to go off on next season, really, you know, focus 100% of your time on filming, which is fucking sick, man.
Yeah, dude, I can't wait. I'm, like, so fucking excited.
Oh yeah. What size is your stance? What is your stance?
My stance, I think it's like 19 and a half. And then 3, -3.
Hmm. So you are basically like almost pigeon-toed.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times it looks pigeon-toed. Like, I get a lot of people sending me messages like, your stance looks weird.
Also, when I've been riding with you the whole season, you would have the school of a foot like a motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, dude. I just, like, honestly, like, I went through so many snowboards that I feel like my hardware for my body is fucked up. And I just feel like I was feeling, like, a lot of stress and shit like that. More ass.
Dude, it looks like you're literally breaking out of your board. Like, your fucking inserts are like, I can't take this shit. They're like trying to get the fuck out of here.
Dude, straight up too much heat.
Dude, straight up. That's exactly what it is, man. You're just fucking, you're smoking. Straight up. I need to figure out a way. Like, I really am like stoked to, you know, like interview other crews. I think that's gonna be like, because obviously I don't want to be have this one as the first one, because like I think it would be like if I have like more content, but like just interviewing us, I feel like it's kind of, you know, weird. But then also, like, there's no, like, I couldn't think of like any other, you know, like source that would just like do something like this and would interview us. So I was like, fuck, why don't I be, you know what I mean? I'm like, people would probably love to hear what we have to say, especially because there's no like young kids going out there and, you know, like actually giving their opinions, where it's like I was saying before,
I don't know, I feel like a huge thing in snowboarding is like kids expect to like get brought on trips and like all that shit, you know.
Like, they expect a paycheck at some point.
Like, they don't try and just go out and have fun and just like film with the boys. And like, I mean, like, there is a few crews that do that, you know.
Yeah, but that's like, you know, that's the core part of snowboarding.
Yeah, it's like most of the people aren't trying to do that. So it's like, I don't know. I feel like with shit like this, with interviews and filming, like, kind of have to do it yourself. You can't expect it to be good.
So, I kind of like it too, because it's like we kind of can edit it our way, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we can do whatever we want.
Yeah, it's not like, fuck, oh, that guy just put words in my mouth, or he put it in the wrong context, you know what I mean? It's like, yeah, I mean, obviously, like, I'm sure people in the future, if like this takes off, they'll be like, oh, fuck, you know, these guys are the ones that are able to edit it their way. But I want to show that, like, it doesn't have to be the people that already, you know, are the names in snowboarding or already, you know, the main spotlights in snowboarding. It can just be, you know, anyone. Yeah, I mean, fuck. I think we got basically covered everything I wanted to go into.
Yeah.
You know, Andre told me flat out no.
Really?
Yeah, I had to do an interview. I think he thought it was going to be like, I'm going to go in and film him or something. But, like, yeah, he told me flat out no. He's so cool, man. It's like, the shit that he does is just too cool.
I love Andre, dude. I love that guy.
He's fucking, yeah, he's 31 years old. And he started snowboarding when he was 18. And I was like, hey, man, I would really love to get, like, you know, your story of how you got into snowboarding. Because obviously,
dude,
it's insane.
I would love to hear his story. So.
I know, right? I think I brought it up to you guys one time when we were at your house, and I kind of threw him under the bus, but, like, yeah. He likes to get into it when it's, you know, like, when it's kind of, like, heart-to-heart instead of, you know, like, he's, like, blasting it out to the world or something.
Yeah, for sure. I feel like.
No, 100%. Yeah, I'm super stoked to, you know, see how this really goes, and it's the first time that, you know, trying something like this.
I think it's really rad, honestly.
Oh, yeah. I want to, like, you know, I think it would be cool to get, like, you know, better at this, have better questions. You know, I really want to get, like, into, kind of, like, get into the grooves and, like, really get under people's skin about snowboarding, too, because I feel like we have a lot of knowledge in this. And, like, really, like I was saying, you know, snowboarder is the only one that really gives their opinion and, like, puts it out there. And I feel like, you know, not that many people really give their opinion, especially if they are on Instagram. It's usually taken the wrong way, like, you know, with the fucking beef that we've been seeing all over fucking comments and shit.
Right. That's just, dude, I don't know what's going on with our shit lately, but it's so funny. I honestly just, like, because I don't really go on Instagram throughout the day.
Yeah.
I have to work all day and shit, so I'm really not on my phone. And it's just so funny the past few days.
You just open it up and you see that you got like 100 new comments and 100 new posts.
Oh my god, dude, it's just been going crazy.
Dude, for real. Like, I was working those 2 days, and same with me, I cannot fucking, like, I can't be on my phone. Luckily, on, like, the hardest day on Wednesday, when Snowboarder dropped our shit, I got the day off. But the day before that, and the day after, I was at work just, like, constantly getting Venmos and shit, and being like, oh my god, how the fuck am I gonna get, you know, do this and that, and fucking get yelled at by my boss. But luckily, I told him, and he was super cool with it. He was like, oh, you're making money doing this? Cool.
Where have you been working at?
I'm at the fucking Sausage Garden in Leavenworth. Doing that for the time being. Yeah. Yeah. Hasn't been, not the best summer. Not, like, you know, most bright. Yeah. I haven't been going out to the beach as much, but, like, I'm definitely making that money.
Yeah, I haven't really been doing a whole lot either. Good work.
So, yeah, I want to see some more fucking skate footy out of you. So even if it's, you know, just like Coeur d'Alene.
Yeah, dude. Probably like 30 seconds so far.
Oh, yeah. Like, is that street footage or is that Coeur d'Alene?
Oh, like street footage.
Oh, sick. Fuck yeah. So you still like booking, or filming just the bookend?
Yeah, we go out to Pullman, like the college a lot.
Oh, word. Dude, fuck. Next season.
Dude.
Yeah, you must know so many spots now, dude, man, all the time skating.
Dude, you're gonna lose your shit when you go there.
Oh, fuck. I can't wait. God damn. I know, I'm super hyped, too, because Jeep Eddie said he wants to follow us next season. So that means that we got a photographer for next season. So we're gonna be more of a professional film crew.
Man, that's sick.
I don't know. I'm fucking hyped for that.
I'm on this little town. Like, out on the way to Pullman, there's this school, this, like, Christian academy, and it has some of the sickest rails I've ever seen. Just, like, and, dude, this is literally East Bump Bump that way. Like, truly. you're gonna be stopped. Because there's really sick skate spots there, too.
Yeah.
And I, like, took all the homies there, and everybody in the car was like, dude, there's no way. And I'm like, trust me, man.
How'd you find it? You just drove up on it?
I set up a fucking... So I, like, worked for this rental company, and I set up tents for events, and, like, went in and stuff like that. And so I go to, like, all over the place, so I see some really cool shit. Like, I found so many spots to work this stuff.
That's what I kind of want to know, too. That'd be cool, like, really getting, like... If we, like, start blowing up on these interviews and stuff, I really want to start, like, interviewing, like, you know, those types of pro snowboarders and seeing, what, you know, like, what their lives were, you know, were like back then compared to what ours are like now.
That would be some cool information for sure. But I don't know.
Yeah, man, I'm going to charge you $1 for it, so.
Yeah.
Maybe spend some money.
I'd take $5 for it.
Oh, no way. Dude, we got a lot of people that were, like, 3, 5, 10. Like, they're like, this is more than $1.
That's sick.
Yeah, people were really hyped. I was, like, really, really surprised with the outcome with that. And then, like, again, I think it really comes back to Judd.
Yeah, that shit was hilarious.
Yeah. I just don't understand, like, people's mentalities when it comes to, you know, like, oh, I just, like, you know, embarrass myself nationally and publicly, and I'm just gonna let, you know, keep it up there and let people hate on me. Like, that's what really got me. Like, wow, dude, you really just left it up.
And, like, I don't know, when I first saw it, I was kind of like, fuck you, that's whack.
Me too.
But then I really don't give a fuck.
The first thing that came to my mind was the same thing, fuck you. But as time went on, I was like, oh my god, this is a blessing in disguise.
It
this
is.
This guy,
like,
yeah, this like, guy just single-handedly got us from, like, the day before that, we made, like, $80 total or some shit like that. The right. Next day, we made, like, $450.
Yeah, like, I feel like so many more people, that's probably why people paid more, you know? Like,
yeah. Dude, people pissed off at Judd.
Yeah.
with your clip, the one that or the one that I copied and posted or copied and pasted today, the one from back in like January or some shit. I sent that to everybody today to see if other people would post it. Like I sent to Adidas, I sent it to fucking everybody, dude.
Which clip was this?
The clip of you doing the switchback blunt pretzel to back tail same way to fucking goddamn messing the whole world up. That clip, I swear to God, that is the most fire line of 2019 and probably ever.
Thank you.
Dude, yeah, holy fuck. Like, when I filmed that, I swear to God, I was jealous because I was like, holy fuck, that was so much better than I think I could ever do on anything. And I was like, fuck, that was insane.
I mean, I think, like, I was the most hyped on the first trick, too, like.
Yeah.
Because it's such a hard trick, and I've, like, never really been able to do it on any other room. And, like, I really liked how I did that one, too, for the fact that it's a whole line of it. I mean, like, I really wish I did the backflip thing.
I'm sure, like, people do say that, but you still fucking did the whole rail. It's not like you fucking, like, actually, you know what I mean? Like, there was no actual, like, you know, scuffs about the run. Like, fucking, it was full and complete. And that last fucking trick was so perfect and, like, so fucking money, man.
That was a really hard one. I love
that.
That
looked fucked up.
I have some other clips on that rail that are, like, the Bradstone.
You did a switch back lip through that rail, and you also did a back lip pretzel set in that spot. Yeah, those are fucked up too, man. That's what I'm saying. This next season, holy shit, to actually get you on a fucking program to get you focused on snowboarding instead of, you know, having to focus on another job as well, it's going to be a life changer.
Oh, it's going to be the biggest season. I have no idea how excited I am.
I really want to, like, use all this stuff to kind of, like, promote / hyping up our next season as well. And, like, kind of, like, I want, you know, like, to, like, really, like, kind of push this off to all our companies. Like, I already got, like, some feedback, but I want to, like, get, like, more feedback from, like, other companies and see if we can push a pot, you know, and, like...
Oh, I was going to say, C3 wants to... on their opening night for, like, their winter store or whatever, they want to premiere a video there.
Really?
Yeah.
No way!
Yeah.
That's so sick!
Yeah, so if you want to do that, I told them, I figured it would be chill. I figured
dude, fuck yeah! Dude, I'd love to have a premiere.
They want to do that. I really want to go to it. It's like, I think, let me see what date it was.
Where is it going to be happening?
At the C3 store in Seattle.
Dude, sick. Honestly, didn't think that we would, like... In my opinion, like, when I first put this out, like, and especially putting it out for the dollar cap, like, I thought people were going to be kind of bummed. And, like, I thought, like, a lot of people were going to give a shit for it. And, like, then again, you know, I think Judd had a lot to help for it. But... I did not see it blowing up like it did, especially because we both, and I really wanted to get at this before when I was talking to you about, like, you know, how you felt about your season, you know, filming with us and doing that, all this and that, you know, like, I really feel like we did not reach our potential, and, like, I know we feel like that.
I feel like, personally, like, people thought my clips were sick, but I just, like, I'm super stressed on it.
That's what I really wanted you to say too, and I was like kind of having you bring that up because I know you and I know you're snowboarding and I know how, you know, like, that's why I was like, can you just talk about, you know, like, you know, how often you were able to come with us, because it really was amazing for the amount of times that you came out with us, but it doesn't show because, you know, obviously people don't know.
Yeah, just like, I'm like, I just feel like I could do so much better, and it almost bums me out, but, like, every time I try and film street shit, I just, like, can't go all in. Like,
yeah. maybe we both like have to focus on really just like working on like just fucking around and having fun first, and then, you know, by the crunch time, maybe the end of the season, going for those, you know, absolute hammer bangers. Yeah, just fucking get those fun ass clips out of the way and fuck around. Yeah,
I can't wait for it to snow. I can't wait to stop working.
Like,
I know I'm gonna be at work and it's gonna snow one day, and I'm just gonna be like, alright, see you guys the fuck later.
This is kind of why I want to like really get into this too. I want to talk to more snowboarders about, you know, kind of like their upbringing, like, you know, what they had to do to get in the sport, and like what their jobs were, like, you know, like how much they were making then, how much they're making now, shit like that, you know what I mean?
I mean, I have to like bust that all day.
Yeah.
A lot of the times I get off work later too, like 5:30 is like
that's a better day than I got though, dude. I fucking hate my hours. I go literally 12 to 9 and it's like I wake up, go to work, get off of work, go to sleep. Like at least 7 to, you know, 5 you have like the afternoon.
Yeah, I can go. I pretty much like everybody at my work thinks I'm fucking crazy because I go skateboard every single day after work pretty much. Like at the park, or I try and go like sell some clips or something.
But they're actually fucking crazy because they don't have any therapy for them fucking shitty hours.
They just like bust ass and everybody's always super tired, but I'm just like, I feel like I've been doing, I started off with someone doing that because like I knew if I didn't, I just like wouldn't be able to.
Yeah.
So I just like,
so you like keep your like the tolerance up, and so your like body is able to keep doing it.
Especially after I got hurt, because I like doing this shit for so long.
That's good, man. You're like getting yourself stronger right now, so you'll be like, you know, at full 120% by the time the season comes around.
Oh yeah, dude, I'll be fucking ready to go.
Fuck yeah, dude. I kept like watching that fucking clip of you like over and over again of you fucking hitting your knee on that rock, and dude, it is so disgusting.
When I watched that clip in the rock today, all right. Like, I was just waiting for that clip. I was like, I hope he put it in.
Are you
all
right?
Oh, yeah, dude. The fucking noise is so disturbing.
I don't think people understand how bad that fucked me up, dude.
I just keep listening to that noise, and it's literally like just straight bone on rock.
I hit my kneecap so fucking hard on that rock.
I can't believe that you were filming me after that.
That was a terrible idea, dude.
I bet, dude. Yeah, you were out for, like, maybe a month after that.
Dude, yeah, I was really out. Like, I couldn't. And it was so shitty because I had to work at Stevens, too. So, like, I had to kind of schedule it. But it was nice because, like, I had 6 days off in a row. My schedule was, like, perfect.
Damn.
And, like, I was so excited. I was like, oh, we're going to go film on these 6 days. Like, it's going to be fucking sick. Like, the first year that we kind of filmed.
Yeah.
And then, yeah, then that happened the first night.
Yeah.
Fucked up, dude.
No, I remember you got that really sick clip of you breaking your snowboard on the closeout rail.
Yeah, I was like, damn, and fuck that board up. That was
just another night where you got two clips, but you also got injured as well and broke your board.
Yeah. Did I get clipped that day?
Well, I mean, nah, but like, You got the clip of you breaking the board on the first rail.
Yeah, that was like 10 minutes into me getting that rail, man.
Seriously. Fucking Andre did that trick the year after, too. I was like telling him how that, you know,
care,
that was
dude.
Your trick that you did the year before.
I don't even care, dude.
No. I'm sure you wouldn't. That was a sick spot, though.
It is. I'd like to do something else.
I don't know. I really want to, like, utilize the second rail somehow.
Yeah, I'd like to hit it in the daytime because, like, when I hit it,
it
was so icy, dude. I was going so fast.
It did look really cool, though, at night.
It does look really cool now.
Yeah, with, like, the spotlight. That was
I feel like we've already come a long way with, like, where we started not very long ago, you know.
I feel it. Like, it's all about, you know, progressing, and, like, that was your first real, you know, snowboarding part that, you know, like, and hitting real street spots too. So like that in itself, for like the clips that you did at that drop rail at the cemetery, that I think really resonated to people as like, you know, that is, that's next level, you know, like that's where snowboarding's heading.
I was hyped. That was like one of the first lifts I got this year.
Yeah, dude, that was, yeah, that was one of your first ones. And yeah,
it was the first clip because I like fucked my ribs up.
Yep.
First time I like actually tried anything. So it had been like a few weeks since I'd like really ridden. And you're like, yo, we're going to go hit the trail. And I was like, fuck, I have to hit the trail. We're not going to do it. I knew we weren't going to be able to hit it again. Like, with the cop.
You took a couple slams too on that rail.
Yeah, dude, that shit sucked.
Yeah. That's a big drop. That's like a 5-7-foot drop.
I feel like I could have done it better too if I was like not just getting off that because my ribs still kind of hurt and I was wearing like a fucking brace and shit. Like on my back, ribs like tight.
Oh yeah, dude, you definitely. And also the fucking cop showed up too and kicked us out.
Yeah, just like how I like spun it the same way out of it. I don't know. It's just like not my favorite. But
everything
like
else was Andre.
I like the stationary angle, honestly. I feel like you can see the foot movement a lot better with that.
I know. I really like that angle too, but I also don't like stationary clips because they just like seem like too dead. Right. Like there's no, I don't know. It seems like after a drone clip, they would put like a stationary shot that with no movement.
Yeah. Like, our filming will be good this year.
Yeah, no, 100%. I'm hoping that, you know,
it's gonna be great. I can't wait. I can't wait to see like what we do.
Yeah, I'm like, what I was gonna say is like, I'm really hyped to have, you know, hopefully Pope come along with us and like have, you know, Jeep as well, so we can have, you know, filmers instead of like, you know, riders always, you know, having to switch off, so we can have, you know, because it is hard with a lot of these spots where it's like we can have a party rail. But then at the same time, there is a likeliness of like a cop or something, you know, something might happen that we might get kicked out. So it is crucial with timing sometimes.
Definitely. Yeah, I feel like if we could all hit a spot together too, we'd like feed off each other a lot better, you know?
Definitely. I don't mind that either. Like, I really liked how a lot of kind of the spots that we hit, you know, we hit like the same spots. Like, yeah, those spots are pretty gnarly.
You know, we definitely hit some like, I don't know, that wood rail was scary.
That was, yeah, the fucking photo that that Paul got of Andre on that rail where it's face on was really sick, and you could really see the steepness of the rail.
Yeah, dude, like that rail's steep and wood and really narrow.
Yeah, think about fucking Petey and goddamn Matt Rob hitting that with no snow on the side.
Absolutely insane.
I know, they were the first ones to ever hit that rail, in my opinion. I mean, definitely. I don't know.
So quick.
Yeah. And they did it, like, I think a worse way, too. Like, at least we had the drop-in ramp, right? They dropped it off the back of my car.
That's true. I mean, yeah, we made, like, a snow drop-in.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Ours was, like, not that bad, but it still was quick.
That was just, like, but it's almost kind of nice because you can pretty much see the whole rail being that close to it, so.
Dude, I just can't believe that you were just fucking board slid. You were board flying those fucking rails, that one and the elbow wood one as well. Like, fuck.
Yeah, I don't really feel like too many people go sideways on the rails. I'd like to do more of it for sure.
Dude, fuck yeah. It seemed like it worked out well.
And, like, I don't even dull my edges either most of the time, so.
Damn, that's some inside information right there.
Yeah, dude, for everybody out there.
Everybody. This guy's got a fucking pigeon-toed stance, and he doesn't defile his edges.
Yeah, and I'm about to ride a 158, too, so it's like the big board is the move.
Oh, fuck yeah. Damn, where are you riding now?
I ride a 156.
Oh, okay. So you're moving up in the world.
I think so. I think I want to at least try it. I mean, I don't know, that might be like too big on me. But
you already riding a, definitely, you know, it's not a small board for you. It's definitely, you know, it's got to be up to, like, around your nose.
Yeah, dude, it's like how people would say your snowboard should fit, like, up to my nose.
Yeah, hell yeah.
Bigger than most people's snowboards.
I don't like seeing people with, like, boards that you're like, oh, that's obviously too short for them.
Yeah, like, I think it's hard to get used to bigger board, but overall, I think a lot better.
Yeah.
Rim, you know, you have more room to, like, crush your board and be, like, in a board flat and shit like that.
Yeah, so pigeon-toed and longboards. That's the future of snowboarding.
The straight stance. I don't know, a lot of people, like, I don't know if you get a lot of messages about it, but I get a lot of messages about my stance.
Oh, yeah. Everyone's like, is it zeroed, or are you negative, negative? And I'm like, I really don't know either. Like,
timing's, like, move around so much, it's honestly probably changes all the time. Like
exactly.
I've been at 3-3, but sometimes I'm riding racer stance. Like, sometimes it's probably, I don't know, fucking slightly pigeon toed, dude. Honestly, I have no idea.
It's super sick, though, because we really fuck with everything. And I feel like it kind of has, like, a little bit on your style as well. Like, I was definitely riding the racer stance for, like, a month this season.
Dude,
and
pretty much all of Superpark I rode racer stance.
Yeah, I remember that, too. I was back to pigeon toed at that point. But, yeah, dude, like, it really, it kind of gives you a different feel. Like, you feel like a different person and also, like, gives you that different style.
Dude, yeah, it's like, I want to go fast and just, like, do different shit.
Yeah, like, you want to carve faster. More with that racer.
I feel like my style is different on a day-to-day basis. Like, slightly.
Yeah.
Like, I try and teach it, like, a different way.
I felt like when I started narrowing my stance more, like, you know, putting it in and in, I started to feel, like, more like a skateboarder.
Yeah, and I mean, I skateboard a lot, too, so I feel like that has a very big input on that thing.
Oh, yeah. I mean, like, it's obvious with you. Like, you can tell that, you know. I mean, when I'm hitting street with you, it's obvious that you have a skateboarder mentality. Like, you know, you fucking, it doesn't matter, you know, if it hurts, you're still going to get the shot.
Yeah, dude, I honestly, like, over time, I feel like I almost like taking slams.
Damn, but man.
I don't like to take slams, but, like, and, like,
but low-key. Yeah, no, I can see that with you, though. It's kind of like, like how you say, you know, like, you're going to see some fucking, you know, you're going to see me get into some fucking in my head, and you're going to see me, you know, throwing some, getting some rage and shit. Like, you can see that really, like, it kind of helps you in a way. Like, some snowboarders, you know, and skateboarders, like, you can tell, like, when they're in a rage, like, it helps them, you know, like, they're, that's them, that's their therapy right there, is, like, taking it out on snowboarding and skateboarding.
Yeah, because I honestly feel like I'm a pretty mellow person. I'm really good.
Oh, yeah, you are. I don't think I've ever seen you mad within 3 years that I've known you.
Unless I'm, like, snowboarding, I feel like
you've
probably seen me freak out a few times.
Well, you see, you know, like, the same with me. I mean, like, I'm a little bit more on edge as a person, though, like, you know, just mainly. But, like, snowboarding, though, like, I'll freak the fuck out if I'm not landing something.
Yeah.
Dude, I wish you were there with the that fucking NTS spot where it was the fucking hop, 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 and I had the hand drag off. I did that like 100 times and I couldn't land it. And that's literally at like the first clip where I'm throwing the board on the ground, like slamming it as hard as I can. That was the spot.
Yeah.
The only thing that Audrey could say the whole time was like, you're gonna get it. Don't worry.
Honestly, I've never filmed like that much street snowboarding, so like, I feel like my frustration could not.
Definitely, yeah. Like, once you're, I feel like spots, you know, like, there's spots that really, like, let you do the trick that you want to do on it, and then there's spots that don't let you do the trick that you want to do on it. It might let you do something else, but, like, that trick that you're trying to do on it, that won't let you do on it, you'll freak the fuck out of that because you think that you can. It's in your head.
It's like, you know you can do it. And, like,
exactly.
But it's just like,
all you think about, like, the whole time going to the spot, you know, like, before, or, like, since you've seen the spot, like, going and set it up, like, all you think about is that one trick and how, like, that's, like, the one that you think would be the best or, like, that you want to see yourself do on it.
Yeah.
Maybe it's not the one that, you know, like, the spot's going to let you do, but, like, yeah, you're going to freak the fuck out because you can't do it.
I think, like, I'm trying to go and not really, like, think about the kind of tricks I want to do on the specific spot. So I've been doing that skating this year.
Yep.
So, like, it's opened my mind to, like, a lot of different tricks and, like, skating shit, or just doing different tricks than I would normally do.
definitely had that happen a few times skating too, where it's like you're trying stuff for so long and then you switch it up. And
it sucks like when you are in your head like that and you're like, oh, I don't want to fucking switch up right now because it's going to be another, you know, like I'm going to have to warm up with that trick too. Like, yeah, that's where I, like, notice that, like, if I go to a spot and I'm just, or if I'm in the park and I'm trying the same trick over and over again, I'm going to get into my head after, you know, like, the first five times that I didn't land it and, like, thought I might on the first five and, you know, it's going to take, like, 150 tries after that. Or, like, if I literally went to that spot and tried literally five times and then switched up my trick and only tried different tricks five times, you know what I mean? I feel like... I just kind of realized that, like, when I would switch up tricks and just, like, do only five tries of each trick, I would come out with, you know, maybe, it's, yeah, I would feel better because I'm landing more tricks.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I feel like it's good to kind of try and switch it up and see what works best a lot of the time.
Yeah, no.
There's definitely times where it's, like, going to take you hours to do a trick. And, like,
sometimes you got to be in that battle.
Yeah, you know, sometimes
I just 100% like there's 50-50 spots and gap spots, you know, where there is only one trick that you can do, and like, yeah, you'd be working on that for an hour.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah, that's what it came down to me with that fucking hop 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 fucking hand drag. Was that was the only clip or trick I could see for that spot, and I couldn't land it, so it just fucking took me so long. I was so mad.
Trying to think something that took me like a fucking long time.
The fucking the cab 2450.
That did take me a minute to get it how I wanted it, for sure.
Oh yeah, and like you did the back one within probably 5 to 7 tries, which, you know, is considerably an easier trick. You did the cab 2 same way within like first try.
Yeah, and like, I'm definitely getting kind of frustrated because I feel like cab 2 450 is like.
Yeah, it was there for you. It was also a couple times where you landed it and then you went right in those little fucking like wooden holes that were right at the end.
Yeah, and it's just like, I don't know, I feel like I try and hold myself to a high standard of how I want to do a trick, and like if I don't do it how I want to, I'm just gonna keep trying it.
That actually, like, that was one of, I was really hyped on that clip, and I actually got a lot of feedback on that clip, but my overall favorite clip out of you from that last season was the one at the cabin, down rail PVC pipe with the fucking, you know, with the notches on it, and to the one that you half cabbed, and then the back one over the gap.
I really like that clip too, and honestly, that was kind of a battle.
That was a really, and we were battling time and light too.
Yeah, it was like I really only probably had like a couple more tries with that.
You did the top half cab. I could barely see.
Yeah, and it's just like, I don't know. It didn't seem like, it doesn't look like a difficult spot, but it was just kind of sketchy because it's like really not very, pretty narrow, and there's like another rail. And...
Yeah, I love that, like the look of the alleyway. I love the sound of the rail that it, you know, the 50-50 made on the PVC.
I love the sound of it so much.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That's what I liked when I used that clip of you from the other alleyway with the two barriers. I really liked the sound of your squeaking binding. Oh, yeah. Hell, yeah. I really like that clip. That was skate style as fuck. With the broken board, I wish you could see it better, though. You can't see it at all.
I would really like to go back to that spot.
Are you all right? Oh, yeah. That's a fun spot.
I would love to do, like, straight up something over.
Fucking neighbors were totally cool with it.
Oh, yeah. We were there pretty late. Like.
Oh, yeah. That was, like, 11 o'clock at night. We just got off of the flat road closeout.
Yeah. We're like, maybe I can ride my snowboard.
Yeah. Yeah, you did. You fucking got two clips, you got two of the same lines on it.
Yeah.
Fucking sick though, man.
I got destroyed. I bought that.
Dude. Fuck the rock.
So,
are you alright?
Yeah.
Only gonna have to go on Street and Pow Jones.
Yup. No, no, like, I really wanna, like. What I want to do is just travel for the snow, like wherever is getting snow during, you know, specific time, like go there, but also like I want to, like, kind of hit resorts on the way, you know? Like, not focus on the resort, but maybe do, like, a day at a resort, you know what I mean? Not, like...
Yeah, let's do that. That's what I'm saying. We can keep up with our Instagram content.
What I also want to really do, though, too, is I want to do a lot of iPhone street shit. And, like, if I have anything on the camera, too, that, you know, like, I'm just going to pass up, you know, like, keep the bangers. But I also want to do, like, some, like, fucking, like, if we can, obviously, backcountry, but, you know, that's here or there. But definitely a lot of street, just iPhone, you know, fucking Insta shit in street.
I feel like people would really like that, too, especially if you have way more clips that we're keeping that we're really hyped on.
Like. Exactly. That's how we, like, hype people up for that next movie, I think, is just, like, literally just feed them the shit that they want to see. And, like, I feel like that's what really hyped people up on. And, like, I feel like we get a lot of... it's also the tricks and shit that we did at Mission. Like, we get a lot of comments and views and likes on the shit that we did at Mission. And, like, it's kind of more than we get, you know, doing street. And I think there's two reasons for that. I think one is because, obviously, the algorithm on Instagram is, you know, it's meant for iPhone clips and, you know, things that were filmed on an iPhone, and they're not meant for, you know, imports from a computer. So the algorithm is kind of fucked with that. But also, I think it's also that people see how fucking, you know, like, how much time and effort we put into those, you know, clips, whereas, like, we didn't have as much time, you know, doing that shit in the street.
And not dollars. Yeah, we, like, got down.
Exactly. Like, if you put in the amount of days that we had at Mission compared to the amount of days on the street, it's probably like 2 or 3% street, 70 fucking 7. I mean 97%. I'm terrible at math.
Literally, yeah. Like, I'd say 95% at Mission. And probably 97. Yeah, that sounds bad.
Exactly. Dude, if I can go next season just with Austin and just focus on street and, like, putting out just, you know, like, literally filming the whole season, I know that we can, you know, we'll go 100% harder than what we did this past season. And he's like, I can't wait to see what you guys got, you know. But I also was like, but we really, you know, like, there's no other way to do it without, you know, money. Like, there's, you know, we have to fucking... That's what sucks to say, is, like, you can't just fucking, like, do any of this stuff without money, and it sucks to ask, and no one wants to ask for money, but yeah, literally had this growing on, yeah.
I have a hard time asking for fucking any snowboard shit, dude. Like, when I fuck my snowboard up on my camera, I don't even want to ask.
I don't know, dude.
I always feel so bad.
Yeah, I don't fucking, I hate asking for money. I can't even, like, you know, put into words, like, the amount of, you know, I guess, frustration I had into even, like, putting out our movie for $1. It was just, like, kind of, like, I am broke right now, and I know the boys are broke right now, and yeah. To, like, do something in order to, like, change our fucking, our shit, so we have, you know, can get our shit together for next season. I thought this would kind of, like, push us and kind of motivate us in a way to try to make more money somehow in order to, because, like, that's a fucked up thing that I kind of saw in snowboarding nowadays. Like, everyone, you know, you're like, what we said before is, like, you're not supposed to ask, you know what I mean? Like, you can't ask for money, you can't ask for this and that, but, like, when you're not asking a company but you're asking people to fund for you, you know, like, it's also, like, it's one of those taboos that's kind of looked down upon in the sport, but it's also like, how the fuck am I supposed to do this and also give you better content if I'm struggling to even be able to pay my rent?
100%. And, like, honestly, I hate to say it, that's, like, a big reason I live in my parents' house. Like,
mm-hmm.
How am I supposed to save enough money for the winter to be what I want to do if I'm paying fucking $800 for rent every month, you know?
I've noticed with anything, any type of, you know, film crew or anything, it takes time. Like, you're gonna have to do it for at least, in, like, the least is 2 years. Like, you know, it's going to take, like, 3 to 5 years for you to get established. And we've already gotten, like, a very, very good start with that getting established. But it still takes, you know, 2 to 3 years, maybe, for the companies to really back you and hop along on board.
Yeah.
But I think that we can do it more with the people. Like, with this Patreon thing, and maybe, you know, like, some other ways, because I really hate how Patreon works, we can get followers that are willing to help us with our goals, with our, you know, with what we want, without, you know, having to really ask them, or, you know, really having to, you know, like, it's mainly like we're just gonna post content. Whoever wants to pay for it can pay for it.
Dude, yeah, it's like, it's not even like we're necessarily asking people for money. It's like, if
they want to, like,
broke snowboarder to broke snowboarder, it's like, not asking for anything, but like at the same time, anything helps us produce more content that people are gonna be stoked on, you know.
Exactly. I feel like the people that really don't understand that is just ignorant kids, you know what I mean? Like, the kids that were liking Judd's comment was like people that don't understand that, you know, we're doing this in order to be able to keep doing this, and there's no other way to do that without money.
Yeah, and it's not even like, dude, we both work full time jobs. Like,
oh yeah,
making it work to the best of our ability. Like, for somebody to like even have the ignorance to say that, it's just, I don't know, it just shows a lot about people, I guess.
I'm glad you feel the same way, because I'm sure when I was with Wild Instinct, like, I would have like four different opinions from everybody, being like, I would never want to ask for money, I would never want to, you know what I mean? But like, I want to do this for my future. I want to keep doing this, and I've noticed, you know, like, there's still pro snowboarders out there that are 40 fucking years old. They're fucking still making money, and it's like, they always made money.
Yeah, it's like, and I don't know, I thought it was really cool, like, how Jed Anderson and his interview, like, we really are risking our lives, like, trying to produce content for everybody.
Yeah.
Dude, like, to the level that he's at, and the spots that he's at, like, to not even have a team fully back you, to, like, paying you to support, like, get the hype.
Seriously.
Out of it. Like, it's kind of fucked up, you know?
That's like how this sport is, like, kind of, that's the way that this sport has gone too, is really just like pushing out the people that are making it better. It's not like I'm straight up like putting them out on the spot or anything, because like, it's great that they're still making money, but it's also awful the fact that, you know, kids like, you know, me and you and other kids, like the Future Shock guys, Brendan Sullivan and fucking Josh Cariola and all those guys, they don't make a dime when they're literally putting their lives on the line.
I couldn't agree more, dude. It's like
with sports, like, you know, fucking these dudes are getting multi-million-dollar contracts for literally, you know, running around a ring all day, and like, you know, the best guy's gonna be making $40 million, where the worst guy's still making $500,000. But with snowboarding, it's like the worst guy could be making fucking I don't know, $30,000 a year, and the fucking best guy could be making nothing.
No doubt. It's like, I don't know, I think if you paid professional snowboarders more,
holy,
like, you would be,
Jake,
more, like, way better content.
Yeah, no, 100%. Like, you know, they're giving to, you know, the people that are not really progressing the sport, so they're taking away from the progression.
No doubt. And I guess it's like, I have the skate contest tomorrow, the winner gets $500. Like, I'm trying to go all out.
Yeah. Hell yeah, dude. I hope for the best.
That's fucking, I don't know, like three weeks for the winter, $500.
Dude, fuck yeah. Like, seriously, when I found out that we made, you know, $450 off of fucking selling our video, I was like, dude, at least that pays for, you know, a few weeks of food and just fucking travel.
Straight up, dude. That's like, yeah, that's like 2-3 weeks for us, you know? Like,
straight up.
That's a
and
trip.
Anything helps.
You know, it's like, I'm going to save that money, you know. It's like, I'm not going to go out and spend it on, like, drinks at the bar. Like, I feel like a lot of people do, you know. Like,
oh, really, yeah.
Saving all my money.
The same way, it's like, you know, when we're in snowboarding, we're in fucking snowboarding. Like,
yeah,
there's nothing else.
It's like, trying to, I feed myself, and that's like,
I think that's like where greatness comes from, kind of, though, is the struggle. So hopefully this next season is, you know, that.
I think it's great when you can, like, I don't know, come up. It's not like we've given any invented by anybody. Like, everything already that we produce is all on our own.
That's what I want to do with it. Like, this is my whole goal. Is like, I want to blow up a brand. Like, start up a brand and start up different, you know, kind of entities in the brand. Like, we have our snowboarding already, and we have our filming, obviously. I want to get into, like, interviews and hopefully be funding us for, you know what I mean? Like, good content. People are going over to that, and they're helping, you know, helping us out.
I don't know. That would just be sick if we could collaborate with, like, a lot of shit, you know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
And that's what my interview thing is going to be, is just, you know, a way to give back to them.
I think people will appreciate that, too.
I'm going to make sure that, you know, if we're doing something, you know, like, we're making something a thing, we're both making money.
Dude, fuck yeah.
Fuck yeah, dude.
I think we can definitely do it, too.
We know that this is us, like, literally out of a whim. Like, we had no idea it was even happening, you know what I mean? And that's where I'm like, dude, so you guys help me out for a year, and I'll show you what we can produce if we're actually putting out for a movie instead of just fucking around.
Dude, yeah, it's like, I'm so excited. I don't know, I'm just excited to show the people that, I don't know, what I've really been trying to do. Like,
oh, dude, I know. I fucking know. Every time I watch it, I literally feel the same thing. I'm like, everything's so good about, like, the video, and I have nothing bad to say about it, but
yeah.
I know that Austin Viz's part is going to be the ender.
I'm so excited, dude. Like, I just can't fucking wait to get down on some rails.
Oh my god, I can't fucking wait, too, to see you, dude. I just fucking know. Like, it's incredible, like, with snowboarding, how you see these amazing fucking snowboarders, you know, like, here, there, and shit.
Yeah.
And it's just about who they kind of associate with, and that's how that's whether they make it or not.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's no way to make it without, you know, association with a good filmer.
Oh, true that.
Yep. And dude, I mean, like, you have the snowboarding, we have the snowboarding, and we got the, you know, we got the film equipment. All we gotta fucking do is just get money so we can not fucking work and just film. And yeah, we both know. Hell yeah.
I think, I feel like people will be surprised after this year. They'll be like, holy shit.
I really want to, like we were saying, I really want to put out, like, Instagrams of the street, too, so we really tease people, you know, like holy fuck, like, you know, like, they're just putting out, like, these, because they're obviously going to know for next season if we're just, like, instantly putting out, you know, street clips on Instagram. Oh, yeah. They're going to know that we are still filming for a movie, like,
oh, yeah.
Obviously, if we have these interviews and we're hyping up, you know, a next season for a movie.
Well, we're going to maybe we'll just film and post street clips on Instagram.
And I was also thinking that not just for them, but for us, you always want to be at a park at least, you know,
one
day, a few days, you know, so you can get your legs back under you.
Yeah, no doubt. Oh, that would be cool.
Well, fuck yeah, man. Well, fucking so stoked to, you know, get in touch with you and be able to fucking shoot some shit about next season and shit.
Yeah, dude, it's been fun.
Fuck yeah, man. And I got like 2 hours of editing on this interview.
Good luck.
Fuck yeah, though. Like, I'm really stoked. I think people are gonna be hyped to hear shit like this from us.
Yeah, thanks to all the people that support us and that bought our video. Really didn't think that many people would want to see it, so it's really cool. To everybody that follows us, that pitches in, like, it's always like a dream, I guess. Pretty dope. Definitely trying to, yeah, do some different shit, for sure.
Fuck yeah, man. Well, hell yeah, dude, I'm super stoked that we were able to talk, and I'm sure that we both want to get to some smoking right now.
Yeah, I gotta go to bed so I can wake up. I'm doing that contest, and I gotta I gotta leave at, like, probably, like, 9:15.
What's that?
The registration's at 10, shit, so.
Ah, hell yeah, dude. Well, fucking killing. Yeah. I hope that you get some fucking money out of it.
Yeah, me too, dude. I'm gonna try my best. I've been practicing, so.
Hell yeah. Yeah, you've been training?
I really have been training. I try and go and skate there, like, couple days a week and get like this, because it's like you got to do like a 60 second run,
Oh, so it's a real contest.
Yeah, it's like 60-second run, two 60-second runs, and like a tech set. It's like a street league contest, basically.
Sick, dude.
So it's like,
are you going to be filmed or anything?
Yeah, I could probably have Jamie film my run, too.
Dude, fuck yeah. Definitely put that out. I'm sure everyone's going to want to see that.
Yeah, it should be fun. So yeah, I feel like I have a pretty stoked on the line that I have. I mean, I don't have it down perfectly, but I'm just going to fucking go for it. Hope for the best.
Sick. Fuck yeah, man. Well,
but yeah,
so stoked.
Dude, me too. I can't fucking wait.
Hell yeah. Well, we got
a few more months, Jake.
Fucking God, I can't wait to get out of work and be like, peace.
Every single day, I just tell everybody, like, I can't fucking wait to leave this place.
Dude, there's a customer today that told me to fuck. So, like, there's these dudes that came in completely hammered, and this dude literally tells his girlfriend that had their son with them to, like, go home because he likes to party. That's like, he was, like, yelling at her. He was like, go home. Well, I'd like to party and have fun with my friends. And, like, she goes home, and I'm like, don't serve this guy. For some reason, my fucking, the cashier dude serves this guy. This dude tells me to fuck off. And, like, I just get so fucking pissed off. All I do is go outside and just think, like, okay, I only have, like, a few months, dude.
I know.
Only a few months.
Dude, I get so mad at work.
Oh, God. This is why, man. We gotta have the hunger so we can have the strive to be able to make this money.
Strive on the time. Oh, I almost...
No, I know, dude.
Fucked my leg up again at work, dude. So bad.
Fuck.
Oh, dude. So I was like, I have to like dolly. We had dolly like 50 stacks of chairs a lot of times. And I was like trying to go really fast. And I fucking fell over with the 50 stack of chairs and the dolly.
Oh,
and landed right on my fucking left leg, dude. And like, first thought, bro, I was like, I just split my fucking shin open again. Fuck my life.
Fuck.
And the fucking point of the dolly hit me like probably like an inch away from where I split my shin open. And I was like, it hurt really bad, but I was fine. Like, I was still nothing.
Dude, thank God. Yeah. Fucking be careful, man. We gotta stay in shape for next season.
I really don't even fuck with chairs that often anymore, dude. Like, I make other people do it. I'm like, nah, dude. Like, I'm straight.
God damn. Well, fuck, that sucks. Glad that you're okay though, man.
Oh, me too, dude.
Fuck. Yeah. But yeah, I got smoke.
Yeah, word.
Hell yeah, man. Good talking to you though, man.
Yeah, you too, Jake. I'm sure I'll talk to you soon.
Oh, hell yeah, you know it.
Alright, well, you have a nice joint.
Alright, bro. Have a good night.
Yep, you too, G.
Peace.
Later.